Hey, everybody, and thanks for joining us today on the Sunday session. And to all the fathers out there, from all of us at Astara, we wish you a happy Father's Day. And let's go ahead and close our eyes and just reflect on our last week or so. The good, the bad, the neutral, just reflect. Now take a long, slow, deep breath through your nose. Gently exhale through your mouth. Again, a long, slow, deep breath through your nose. Exhale through your mouth. Just be still. Keep your eyes closed. Again, take a long, slow, deep breath through the mouth, or through the nose, sorry. Exhale through the mouth. A long, slow, deep breath through the nose. Exhale through the mouth. Keep your awareness on your heart. Your eyes are closed, your awareness is on your heart. Gently and silently repeat, I am surrounded by the white light of the Lord Christ. Of the Lord Buddha. Of the Lord Rama. Of Master Kutumi. I am one with these great teachers. I am constantly bathing in their white light. I am one with the Lord Christ. I am one with the Lord Buddha. I am one with the Lord Rama. I am one with Master Kutumi. Only good shall come to me, only good shall go from me. Be still. I am surrounded by the pure white light of the Lord Christ, of the Lord Buddha, of Rama, of Master Kutumu. I'm surrounded by the white light of God. Jehovah. 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 Yod He Vah He. I'm surrounded by the white light of the solar logos, the aspect of God associated with the sun. Om Pur Uva Swa Tat Savitur Rani Vargo Devasha Dimahi Dino Nana Asuro Dayat. Only good shall come to me. Only good shall go from me. Give thanks. Think of a prayer you'd like to offer up. Hold this prayer in your heart. Offer your prayer up. Great architect of the universe, may I be a channel through which the holy ones approach the world. May I be a center of radiation of thy power. Teach me to travel light, that I may better gain the heights and break the bonds that bind. Teach me to give myself entirely to thy service, to attune myself to thy will. Teach me to lay down the small personal life for the cosmic greater life. Teach me to love with the love of God. Jehovah. 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 I give thanks. We are joined by Reverend Tammy, And so, Reverend Tan, you have a few words.
Thank you, Reverend Greg. It's nice to be with you all again on another Sunday. It's just another opportunity to just kind of breathe into the beauty and the blessings that life is. I'm so grateful to be here with you all on this Father's Day. You know, it's one of the things that we talk about when we think about in the terms of spirituality, when we think about the divine masculine, that spirit is this space within us that moves and acts, and mother God, our nature, the physical, the material, that all of that is within us. So we are made of mother and father God. And we create this balance. And one of the ways where our balance shows up is in our auras. And in our discussion today, I was really looking at first degree of the Astara's Book of Life and lesson 10, page 22. So we're looking at etheric and auric emanations. And so often in what's becoming popular is a lot of conversations about law of attraction and things like that. And what I love about the Astara message is that we look so much deeper into what that actually is. And we're looking at the balance between how are our auras telling a story about us. How are we telling the story of who we are just by seeing what's here? So we can look at our own auras as an inner record of our inner planes of being, our thoughts and our actions, our feelings, all of that are reflected in our auras. And we can see that within us, we are, as Arlene Cheney says, we are God to our own individual world. And we actually can shape our destiny, but how we're thinking and by what we're doing. And so often, you know, we look at the things that are that play a part in what our life looks like. We may have karmic seeds. We may have lessons that we came to this life to learn. But when we think about our memory and our perception of all of these, when we have a certain context for everything that occurs, no matter what happens to us, we continue to keep our aura in balance, right? We keep our aura balanced between what's going on in the physical realm and what's going on in the spiritual realm. We've all heard about people who are very attuned with the spiritual realm, but they're not tending to the material realm. And sometimes I think people think that if we are truly spiritual, we focus on the divine and not the material. When in actuality, if you look at the Bible, it says, seek ye first the kingdom of God, the kingdom of heaven, and all these things will be added to you. So we seek first the divine presence, and we balance that knowing that all of the physical needs are also being met. And we had talked last week about how the physical needs, everything we need already exists in the realm of spirit. And so how we think and act and behave has everything to do with what we're attracting to our auras. So as we have an aura of love and of kindness and aspiration and goodness, our auras begin to reflect these jewel tone beauty and light. And as we reflect that, more of that is attracted to us. Like is attracting like. So the more that my aura is clear and beautiful with these golden tones and this beautiful heavenly music, it's attracting more of that. However, when I'm subjecting myself to greed and selfishness and a lack of self-awareness, my aura gets murky and unclear. So as we are clarifying and purifying our intentions with regard to who we are, we find that these beautiful auric colors, we find that they attract cosmic radiations to us, not only from the solar sun, but from the great central sun of the universe around which all of our solar system revolves. And Erlene even says that cosmic radiations also pour from the Godhead, the highest plane of our universe. So these are things that are always pouring down. She says that the radiations rain upon us perpetually, whether or not we're receptive to them. So by clearing our auras, by being the masters of our own internal universe, our own destiny within us, what we're actually doing is we're opening ourselves up to attracting the being receptive to all that's pouring from the Godhead. And we know when we start looking at this, what is the Godhead, we start looking at love and light and the highest emanations of all that is. So our highest soul is coming to us because we are attracting those radiations from the Godhead and from the entire cosmos. So Erling talks about, as an Astarian, there are several steps we can take to avail ourselves of that proper attunement. And remember, last week we talked about conductivity. What are the steps to being conducive to these highest divine energies? And the first she talks about is express positive faith, which is believing firmly that the cosmic radiations are there waiting for you to indraw them and to make that a part of our being. So it's already there, we're just breathing it in. So what comes up for me is, as I expand my lungs, I expel, I release breath, and then I breathe in breath. Now, am I creating the breath, the air, whatever I'm breathing? No, I'm allowing it in. It was already there. And so when I think about the lessons that the cosmos, that the Godhead has for me, what I'm doing is I'm releasing what I think is already true, that's limiting for me. And I open up myself to the breath that's there. I open myself to the breath of life. I open myself to prosperity. I open myself to longevity and health and good fortune. I open myself up to what the radiating light is already for me. I open myself and I breathe in with my jewel-toned aura all the beauty. And what we're having is positive faith. Now, we're not having faith in something outside of ourselves that we're hoping that someone will bless us externally with. What we're having faith in is knowing what divine presence is. We have divine faith in knowing that we are part and parcel and cannot be separated from that divine presence. So we're not having faith in something else. We're having the faith of God, just how in the divine prayer we're saying, may I love with the love of God. We have faith with the faith of God, knowing that that faith is our natural heritage. It is our divine spiritual birthright. So I have, with a part of the divine beingness in me, a knowingness that all that I ever need is right here for me, and that there is a loving presence that has for me only good, that is only bringing to me, attracting those jewel-toned beauty and goodness, those auric emanations coming from the cosmos, is attracted to the auric emanations coming from me. And I know that I am a match, that I am completely attuned with and in love with and the love of the divine. And knowing that, I regularly affirm, that's the second step, regularly affirm that I am a part of the divinity and nothing but good can come to me. And so this affirmation creates a positive command in our subconscious, which once it accepts that command, sets to work immediately with gigantic powers, to bring to me all good to my life and being. All good is coming to me. So what I'm doing is I'm training my subconscious mind. I'm creating this part of myself that only says, yes, let's do that. I'm creating that not just from my mind power, I'm creating that from my divine mind power. I'm not creating it from my ego that's based in separation and lack and limitation. I'm creating from that divine space that's reigning through the universe as me, then through me, that's attracted to me. So when I consider prosperity and I look at what might look like lack in my life, I can think about, well, I am the faith of God. I am the love of God. The divine flow of the universe is working as and through me. So what is true about God in the realm of prosperity? In the realm of financial prosperity, I think about, in the Christian Bible, it talks about the cattle on the thousand hills. I think about the blades of grass. I think about the stars in the sky and in the universe and the universes, that there is limitless quantity already manifested, and that there is unlimited qualities in the realm of the potential. So I know that there is nothing such as lack. And so I call into myself the affirmation, knowing that the limitlessness of the divine lives in me. And so I call that into being. So every time I am confronted with what looks like lack and limitation, I know that there is divine love. When I look at if I'm feeling lonely, I know that I am one and connected with all life. And I can know that I am in the love of the divine, and there's no limit to love. And so I attract to me love. I attract to me friendship. I attract to me community. I attract the best and highest friends. And I know that all is good. So as I affirm, instead of looking at what it is I don't want, I look at what is true about spirit only wanting good for me, and I'm affirming that. So I'm not just speaking my fear, I'm actually speaking my faith. And by speaking my faith, I affirm that there is something extraordinary for me that I've never even thought of. And so I sit here in an expectation of good, knowing that I'm looking for it to show up. I'm just sitting here waiting to see what good's going to show up. And any situation that I'm in, because I know that my perception and my memory is transmuted in the highest forms of light, everything that I see and I experience, I know that it has only good for me. That there is a cycle of life in the universe, and I know that I am living this experience, and I can't control everything that happens. What I can be in charge of is this mini universe inside of me and the way that I perceive it. And then that impacts the way that I remember it. And then my experience on this planet is defined by how I perceived and how I remember it. And I choose to remember that through all my journeys in life, I affirm that God has only been good, that it has been a journey of highs and lows, of mountains and valleys, of light and dark. But through it all, I know that I have been dearly loved by the Creator. And I carry that with me, knowing that whatever I face in the future, I am divinely guided, that I am the love child of the divine. So holding steadfastly to the good is the third step. And once we have succeeded in this tremendous accomplishment, the subconscious will become our most powerful ally, attracting out of the ethers about you all the radiant good there is. I always think about that. It attracts from the ethers of the cosmos all this good. You know, sometimes if I'm looking at my bank account, or I'm looking at a bill, or I'm looking at what seems like lack, and I think, oh, I have this much to accomplish, that much obligation, I realize that I'm looking at it from the wrong perspective. Because the truth of the matter is that there is endless source in the universe. And I have no idea the goodness that can flow to me. I have no good idea about the abundance of financial prosperity and the amount of service that I can be in the world that really makes a difference. I realize that my ideas of where things would come from and in what quantity may be limited, because I may be trying to have my ego sort my problems instead of knowing that all of this good is coming from the auric source of the cosmos. And number four, the fourth step, the most excellent method of constantly recharging your aura with positive elements is frequently to affirm the segment of the Astarian affirmation. And we know this one. If you know it, say it with me. I am surrounded by the pure white light of the Christ. Nothing but good can come to me. Nothing but good shall go from me. I give thanks. I give thanks. I give thanks. And we should repeat this, Erlene says, several times daily, and particularly in times of irritation when something is annoying. And when we are apt to allow the negative charges to enter our aura, when anger boils up within you, in a way that would not be normal. I know that I recently was on a plane, a flight, and it was delayed by hours and hours and hours. And there were children screaming and screaming for almost the entire trip. And, what I do is I thought about it and I said, I could be really irritated. I could be really frustrated by, hearing the delays and by hearing the children screaming and hearing the mothers yelling at them. And I thought, well, my perception is in my control. So who am I? And I started thinking, yeah, I am surrounded by the white light of the Christ. And so what I started doing was just choosing to be at peace in the face of anything, even the space of delays, in the space of sitting on a plane, in the space of children screaming. And I just took on that I was light. And I brought on that the entire plane, instead of being tensed up with the sound and the what was going on, that there could just be the white light in that moment. And just in that moment, in that space, I become a light bearer into a situation that is less than the light that I want it to be. So I get to be an agent of powerful light and change in any circumstance, just because I choose to be. And so this is an excellent time for us to say the affirmation that I am surrounded by the white light of the Christ. So I just filled that entire plane with white light. And what showed up was, the baby fell asleep eventually. And there became a shift in the feeling, at least that I experienced in the whole trip. And I noticed that the people around me seemed to relax. So what we can do is we make this an integral part of our being. And number 5 is learn to live in an aura of happy expectancy with an exalted feeling that something very, very wonderful is going to happen. It's about to happen. So in the midst of the problems that come, in the midst of the human experience, we hold our glad expectations that we will be shown how to deal with the problem. And we can be what I always like to call, instead of the opposite of a paranoia, we're pronoia. And that is, instead of people are out to get me, I have it that everyone is an agent of the divine working for my growth, working to help me. So even when something is coming that seems to be against me, I start looking with happy expectation on how does that actually work for me? If I'm given a correction, wow, that's really good that I found that out this way. Now I know that maybe there's something I can shift. Maybe there's something for me to transform. Everything that happens, I explore it from the pronoia perspective. I live in happy expectation. That doesn't mean that we have to be happy all the time. That doesn't mean that there isn't a time for grieving and a time for sadness and that there isn't a time for joy. There is a time for all of it, but behind all of that, I know that there is only good. Behind all of that, all the range of emotions that I may experience, I know that I get to be light at all times. And so it says, perhaps in some simple way, perhaps in some mysterious way, but the cosmic forces which are your own will never desert you so long as your attitude is one of supreme faith, supreme expectancy. So at the same time, we do everything in our power and we know that divine works through us. So if we are allowing the spirit and the flow to work as us, spirit has an outlet for being able to create and cause that beautiful thing. So we do the walking, but God guides our feet. We do the walking, but God guides our feet. So even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. I know that in this experience, I am never alone. I am always surrounded by the beautiful white light of the Christ. And I know that my aura is filled with the beautiful jewel tones of the most beautiful spirit, that our auras are completely immersed and one with the white light of the Christ. So as we go through this week, let's continue to say our affirmation to ourselves in every instance and every circumstance, knowing that God is good and all is well. Namaste.
Thank you, Tammy. Let's take a few moments and close our eyes and just reflect on the things that Reverend Tammy brought to our awareness. We will utilize a meditation given by Moses to accelerate healing, and it actually improves the emanations and projections that come from us. It helps to make us a vessel of light. Put your awareness on your heart. Your eyes are closed. Your tongue is gently touching some part of the roof of your mouth. Move your awareness to your navel. Move your awareness to the top of your head, the crown. Just let go. Put your awareness on your heart, the center of your chest. Move your awareness down to the navel. Move your awareness to the top of your head, the crown. Just Just let go. Put your awareness on your heart. Move your awareness to the navel. Move your awareness to the top of your head, the crown. Just like your awareness is on your heart. Move your awareness to the navel. Your awareness to the crown. Your awareness is on the top of your head. Just let go. Your awareness is on your heart. Move your awareness to your navel. Move your awareness to the crown, the top of your head. Just let go. Maintain your stillness. I will say one of the holy names of God. Yehovah Elohim. Al-O-A-V-A-D-A-H. Adonai Malkur. Yod-Heh-Vah-Heh. Yehovah Elohim Al-O-A-V-A-D-A-H Adonai Malkut Yod-Heh-Vah-Heh Yod-Heh-Vah-Heh Yod-Heh-Vah-Heh. Put your awareness on your heart. Move to your navel. Move to your crown. Gently let go. Yehovah Elohim Al-O-A-Va-Da'af Edonai Melkud Yod-Hei-Va-Hei Yod-Hei-Va-Hei Yod-Hei-Va-Hei. Gently move around a little bit. Just gently move your body, wiggle your fingers, wiggle your toes. Thank you for joining us for our Sunday session. Happy Father's Day to all the fathers out there. And all of you, go in peace. From all of us at Astara, we love you and we're grateful to know you. Thank you. Hope to see you soon.
Bye, everyone.